Hello, my friends. I'm Rich Larson, and I'm the IRC Tire Guy. Today, we've got a special technique episode on a subject that most guys don't realize actually requires a high level of technique. In fact, I didn't even realize that I somewhat excel in this technique until I had quite a few guys point it out to me. Today, we're talking how to crash. I get the question all the time, especially after posting a crash clip. People hit me up via comment or direct message and ask, "How are you so good at crashing?" Originally, I didn't think much of it. Really, I just shrugged it off and said, "I guess I have good reflexes." But then I really started to think about how and why I'm good at getting out of those really sketchy situations with minimal damage to my body and my bike. I realized my ability to crash efficiently comes from the same ability I may have in being able to succeed in a specific technique or even conquering a larger obstacle that may look impossible to the average rider. The truth is, I've just failed more times than you've ever tried. And that's really it. That failure on giant sketchy obstacles, or even failure when I was first learning a technique as simple as balance. When you search for success and repeat something that's truly challenging over and over until you get it, you'll find you actually become better at failing than you are at success. Of course, success is the goal and usually the end result. But what most people don't see is the hours of failure that go into finding that success. And after hours of failure, literally hours of it, you get pretty good at failing. Truthfully, that's the reason I'd say I'm pretty good at crashing. With thousands of hours on a motorcycle, I've crashed a lot. Through all this failure, I have an increased ability to understand when things are going to go wrong. That, of course, helps. The amount of time I've put in on the bike has obviously increased my control in all facets. So, step one to this or any technique is put in the time. But there are some tips that I can apply to your training that will speed up the progression in failing. And that's what we are going to go over today. The first tip, other than putting in the time, is improve your balance. I know I talk static balance all the time, but your ability to balance, correcting from left to right and staying in the middle of the bike will make all the difference, especially when it's getting technical. If you find yourself at the beginning of a crash and you have that increased ability to balance, that will ultimately slow down the crash, giving you a longer amount of time to move and save yourself accordingly. An increased ability to balance also helps you keep your feet on the pegs, which brings me to my second crashing tip. You're always more efficient on the bike, even when crashing, when your feet are on the pegs. When you're in a seated position with your feet off the pegs, you can't move. When you stand up with your feet on the pegs, you can actually jump off the bike more efficiently. I've mentioned this example before, but it bears repeating, especially when we talk about crashing. With the bike off, start with your body all the way to the back of the seat. Then, with both feet off the pegs and planted on the ground, move as far forward as you can on your seat. Now, with one foot on the peg, repeat moving from as far back to as far forward on the seat as possible. Notice the difference in efficiency and your ability to move your weight back and forth on the machine. It's obviously way easier with one foot on the peg, but if that's not convincing enough, try doing the exact same drill while moving. If you're moving with both feet off your pegs, it's nearly impossible to efficiently adjust your position on your machine. Even with only one foot on the peg, your ability to move your body back and forth in relation to what your bike is doing is greatly increased. Keeping a foot on the peg will assist you in being able to jump off your bike when needed, especially in those sketchy situations. Speaking of jumping off the bike, it doesn't hurt practicing efficiently getting off your bike. Your ability to quickly step completely off to the side of your bike or in the direction you may be falling is extremely important. Learning how to get off your bike with your foot planted on the ground, or more importantly, stepping directly off the peg to the ground, will increase your ability to save you and your bike in those sketchy situations. A great way to practice this is on a steep incline or side hill. Of course, practicing where you are comfortable, but learn how to jump off the bike to the downhill side of your machine without tipping over. Every time I practice this, I'm focused on using as little throttle as possible. Less throttle equals safer. This is honestly not only a drill in saving you and your bike during a crash, but it's a drill in throttle and clutch control. After you jump off your bike, the focus should be on slipping the clutch and adding just the right amount of throttle to keep the machine in one place. The more you can slow down the crash, the better off you will be. Some final tips I can give is, before committing to a sketchy section you may not be 100% sure about, find an out. Make a plan where you can step off safely, or a spot where you can stop your machine from moving. Always think in terms of, where does my rear tire need to make it to so I can reset and then continue forward. Crashing definitely doesn't come easy. I can tell you, I've had a lot of blood, bruises, and broken bones, but it's through these failures that I've become stronger, not only physically, but mentally. They aren't really failures, they're more lessons, and you have to put in the time to learn them. I hope these breakdowns are helping you guys improve your hard enduro and trail skills. I hope you guys are enjoying the channel, and if you are, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, as well as follow us on Instagram at IRCMoto and my personal Instagram page at RichLarson511. And until next time, keep shredding.